Okay, back to what I was saying. Our words are alive. And seeing the devil is banking on us not knowing the power of our words. That's why the Bible say my people perish because they lack knowledge. Because we look at words and we think words ain't nothing. You got to understand we are fighting an invisible battle. We are fighting a battle that you cannot see. This is a battle in the spiritual realm. And the enemy is banking on us not knowing what's going on in the realm of the spirit. You got to begin to understand that the enemy wants us to continue to be ignorant. The enemy want us to continue to make agreements with him and we don't even know it. So when you open up your mouth and you say blessings, when you say I'm sick as a dog, you got to begin to understand that you have now made an agreement with sickness. Why do you say that? Because it says in Amos 3:3, how can two walk together unless they agree? So when you open up your mouth, you form an agreement with sickness. When you say I'm sick as a dog, now that spirit of sickness have permission to live on the inside of your body. Well, you know what? Nobody will never love me. Nobody will never care for me. You got to understand when you form an agreement, when you begin to agree with the lie of the enemy, guess what? You are giving the enemy permission to take hold of your body. And a lot of times the enemy is taking hold of our bodies and we're not realizing. We're thinking that it's us because we don't understand the laws of the spirit. You got to understand it's illegal for a demonic spirit to operate in the atmosphere unless it's operating through a body. You got to understand these demonic spirits. I like to always remind people in Revelation 12, when Satan got kicked out of heaven, him and a third of the angels was kicked onto earth. And the Bible says to deceive mankind. He deceived mankind because he's an invisible being. You got to understand Satan is the prince of the air. He's waiting. What you mean the prince of the air? In other words, when you speak negative out your mouth, he got permission to bring what it is that you're saying to come inside of your life. He got permission to bring hardship. He got permission to bring pain to your life because when we begin to speak negative, when we begin to think negative, we give the enemy permission and we have formed an agreement with the enemy unknowingly. A lot of times we're so comfortable being sick. We're so comfortable being hurt. We're so comfortable being bitter, not understanding that the enemy is using your body rent free. A lot of times we got a lot of ailments in our bodies and we don't recognize that it have come from the words that we spoke, or either it have come from generational curses. You got to understand in the Exodus, the Bible say that God said that whatever that we do, it will affect time for generations. I'm going to say that again. Whatever that's going on in your life, you are affecting your children, lives before they even get here. Just how you think, just by what you speak. See, a lot of times we don't look at ourselves like we have this kind of power. That's why the devil, he banks on deceiving us. The Bible says my people perish because they lack knowledge, because we go based on our feelings. Understanding in the kingdom of God, it's not based on your feelings. It's not based on your emotions. Can I tell you, you powerful even when you don't think you're powerful? Can I tell you, you are healed even when it don't feel like you heal? You got to begin to understand God want to change our mindset. We got to understand that God lives in our mind. He lives in your soul. You think some people think that God in the church building? No, God is a spirit and he possess your mind. That's why when you confess with Christ, you say, I confess that Jesus is my personal Lord and Savior. I ask you to lead and guide me. You got to understand when you call him into your life, he begins to lead you and guide you and he shows you the right way. And see, and this is why we got to be careful of what we're putting in our mind, what we're putting in our soul, because you are affecting your life by what you're doing. I want you to turn your Bibles to Proverbs, the 6th chapter. When you look at Proverbs, the 6th chapter, let's look at verse 2. He says, if you have been snared with the words of your mouth. A lot of times we are trapped by the very words that we have spoken. We are trapped by the very words I can't do this. This job is too hard for me. I can't afford this house. I can't afford this car. I won't get, nobody will marry me. Nobody likes me. You got to understand, we are trapping our own selves in a demonic agreement by the words that we speak. And a lot of times we don't even understand it because you thinking that you're in your feelings, not understanding those are demonic spirits that they're putting thoughts. Do you not know that the devil is the, he's a deceiver. He's a liar. He will put something on your mind and he's waiting on you to agree. Do you not know that the devil can't do nothing in your life unless you agree? And so therefore, when you listen to negative thoughts in your mind and you agree that I'm sick, you agree that I'm not going to get the position, guess what? You have yield your will over to the devil, and the devil is trying to fool you to make you think that it's you when it was him all alone. This is why we got to stop thinking that the devil is a human being. The devil is a demonic spirit. He is an invisible being that lives on the inside of man's soul. He wants to live inside of you, and so that's why he banks on you talking negative about yourself, talking negative about your family, about your life, because you begin to form demonic agreements. The devil loves to see hardship. He loves to see division. He loves to see separation. He loves to see hurt and pain, because when these things are operating in your life, it's an indication that you have demonic agreements in your life. Can I tell you, when you see a lot of death, a lot of destruction, when you don't see things are changing in your life, seem like you're stuck and things are always getting worse. You look at your family as a whole and it seems like the family member, you know, it's like everybody's staying in the project. Nobody's got their college degree. Nobody graduated from high school. Nobody's married. Nobody have their own business. Everybody is struggling. People are having teenage pregnancies. You got to understand, a lot of people are being abused. A lot of people are being raped. A lot of people got cancer. A lot of people got high blood pressure. You got to understand that those are demonic agreements in the bloodline. You got to understand that the devil, he wants to stay in the bloodline because he can begin to say, we got that family over there. Everybody have a heart attack. Everybody over there got breast cancer. Everybody over there got prostate cancer. When you got these things going on in the family line, is because the demonic agreements are in operation. And see, until somebody begin to wake up and say, wait a minute, how come we see all of this going on in our life and how come it's not changing? It's not like that in their lives, because you got to understand that what we do, it affects time for generations. And you got to understand that's the spiritual law. The spiritual law say what we do. And this is why we have to live a life of stop being offended when we're hearing the truth. If what I'm saying is you, don't get mad at me. Don't get upset at me. But use the information to change your life. Can I tell you? I'm not telling you nothing that somebody told you. I'm telling you what things that I see that is changing my life, where my life is being changed personally, because these are demonic agreements that I came into in my life that it affected my life. It affected my marriage, my children, my health, just because of what I was thinking, just what was spoken over my life. Because a lot of times you got to understand that our words are so powerful that you got to understand that I told the people Sunday, God is a spirit and God does not have a mouth. So when God say, let there be light, he thought it in his mind first. And when he thought it in his mind, then it manifested. And so you got to understand. So God, he speaks to us in our mind. And then he speaks to us in our mind what he want to see done in our life. And then he waits on you to speak it. You got to understand, the Bible is a book of laws and patterns. And everywhere you find the pattern, we should jump in the pattern and we're going to get the result. But a lot of times we get upset with God because we just think, because we spoke it and we think God's supposed to do it, when the devil got our mind, but we want to speak God's word. We got to understand that's out of order. We got to understand that God lives in your mind. He wants you to think the way that he thinks. He wants you to see yourself the way he sees yourself. So a lot of times we operate in self-sabotage. We are sabotaging ourselves. Bless this woman of God. We are sabotaging ourselves by the words that we speak. We are sabotaging ourselves even when we don't educate ourselves that's going to help us to get out of these generational curses. You got to understand the devil is banking on us being ignorant, thinking that it's going to eventually change. Can I tell you, I was one of those type of people. I would pay my tithes and offerings, and I'm like, God, when am I going to be blessed? When is all these things going to happen in my life? Because I was not reading. I was not educating myself, and I never saw the blessings manifest until I started recognizing how I thought. I thought negative about myself. So how could God bless somebody that thinks negative about the very place where he lives in? God can't do what he need to do in our lives if we're always thinking negative. And see, and this is what it says in Proverbs 6:2. He said, if you have been snared with the words of your mouth, he said, have you been caught with the words of your mouth? Do this then, my son, and deliver yourself. So you deliver yourself by your paying attention to your thought. A lot of times we are in bondage. We are in agreement. We begin to get into a relationship when we know a person is not good for us, but because it's what our flesh wants. We got to understand God said that we snared ourselves. Can I tell you, if you're wounded,